Now there were rails and tunnels and roadbeds. But what about cross ties? Why, our railroads need the lumber of 1,000 great forests. You show me the giant who's gonna cut that timber.
Paul Bunyan, Paul Bunyan, there ain't nobody who can hold a candle or an axe handle to Paul the Lumberman. Paul Bunyan lived so long ago that you may wonder how I know.
So
way up in Minnesota, this earth began to rock one morn, and all the folks knew Paul was born. And ships were wrecked going round the horn in southern Minnesota.
I'll tell you how he came to be, the son of a great white oak was he.
His father was a redwood tree from out in California.
That's western Minnesota, Paul Bunyan, Paul Bunyan. There ain't nobody who can hold a candle or an axe handle to Paul the Lumberman. Paul Bunyan grew so very tall, he could not stand up straight at all.
He said, you'll have to leave St. Paul
and maybe Minnesota. He laughed and the earth shook far and wide.
And once they say Paul Bunyan cried,
and hundreds drowned in the tide that flooded Minnesota. So off to the piney woods he went, where he built a camp of great extent.
And with his shirt he pitched the tent that covered Minnesota.
Paul Bunyan, Paul Bunyan, there ain't nobody who can hold a candle or an axe handle to Paul the Lumberman. One day when Paul was rambling round, he dug a river in solid ground
to float his giant timber down to the Gulf of Minnesota.
Paul Bunyan had a great blue ox, its length was 100 city blocks, and when it walked, he'd stop and talk
in all of Minnesota. Paul Bunyan's ox was quite well known, its weight was 100 million stone.
They called him Babe because he wore half grown,
and he lived in Minnesota. Paul Bunyan, Paul Bunyan, there ain't nobody who can hold a candle or an axe handle to Paul the Lumberman.
He took Arizona in his hand and burned his finger through the sand. He made a canyon and called it Grand in southwest Minnesota.
To list his great deeds one by one, and if I were to mention all he's done, in 100 years I'd have just begun to talk about Paul Bunyan.
When he died so hard, he shook the ground in